give way. The anointing will work.
Amen.
Even Jesus, the Son of God, for 30 long years for the anointing. The Bible says he started his preaching ministry and the age of 30. He went to John the Baptist. He said, "Please, my man, please baptize me." John the Baptist said, "You're greater than the greatest. You're better than the best. Hey, you are bigger than the biggest. I can never anoint you. I can never baptize you." Jesus said, "Hey, John the Baptist, baptize me. I also need the anointing. The Holy Spirit came down in the form of a dove and rested on Jesus. Even when Jesus was anointed, Jesus was ordained, Jesus was smeared with ointment, with the oil of the Holy Ghost. And after Jesus was anointed, he went to the temple. In the book of Luke chapter 4, he took the scroll and said, "The Spirit of the Lord is upon me, because he has anointed me to preach the gospel to the poor. He has anointed me to bring healing to the broken hearted. He has anointed me to bring deliverance.
Hallelujah.
High five. Because I was in that mood. But today, I'm not in that mood. The thanks for me. We want to run after sun.
This
is last thing.
Isn't
that?
Hallelujah.
You two want us to last
thing.
Hallelujah. You do things today. Tomorrow you
change.
When the Son of Man comes, shall he find faith, my
brother?
Shall he find faith? How about you never get a chance? Shall he find faith? Hallelujah. Today you're born again. Your spirit
feels.
You like your church. You like the programs of your church. Tomorrow.
The
revival is here.
Thank you.
I was listening to TV Joshua the other day. He says, you know, when I cast demons out of a person, that life is worth trillions of dollars. Not million dollars. Not billions.
Trillions.
The life of one person. Oh, to some. Jesus. The blood of Jesus was shed for that person. And there is no better price than the blood of God. If people had to go and buy the blood of Jesus, how much do you think it would cost? Do you think you would afford it? Because I cannot. I'm not a man. 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 I What is this thing you are busy with? When the kingdom of God suffers violence. And the Bible says the violent takes by force. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I challenge you. Live for God.
Yes.
Amen.
Devote your life to God. Devote your life to God. In the book of John,
chapter 4, verse 34,
Jesus says, "Have a heart as a hill." Banutwa mufanijo. Banakoje mo lafunijo. Our Jesus akoje mo lafunijo. Kini no utimo. And there is food that I eat, which you do not know about. My food, my meat, namayaka, kill it at my food, my meat, is to do the will of the one who sent me. The one who chose me. The one who ordained me. The one who knows. Did you talk? Are things that you do?
And I did you say
glorify God.
Deep palm sounding.
Or not. You don't know the joy I experience every Tuesday. When I am sometimes we leave here at 7 o'clock, sometimes 8 o'clock. And we started at 11 in the morning. But everyone, even if you are born again, you will have to be born again again. So it's so meaning comes in here. And it's deliverance again. And it's praying for you to get in a breakthrough. We will keep building this kingdom. Makuku gave us this vision. Winning and transforming cities for Christ. Nobody will stand in our way. No devil will stand in our way. Jesus wants people to be born again. He wants people to be saved. He wants you to bear fruit at last. But because of our open air, money happens. But how are you going to do
it?
You don't know how many millions of people not married. And there is regret there. The husband that I married.